things that happened to me in March of 1961 when I first took psilocybin. In one moment, so many thousands of things happened that 30 years later, I am still growing into what happened to me that day. And I know some of those things, or I know them, but I don't know them. I intellectually know them, but I don't live as if I knew them. Most of us know more than we live as if we did. It's very frustrating at times. I mean, I kid about it, like we're all one, but it's my television set. Now, how do we integrate all of the levels of the realities that we have touched and that we know? Those of you that have had a near-death experience have gone out of your body. How do you integrate that so that you are, as Christ said, in the world but not of the world? What does that mean to integrate it? Many of us have sensed our interdependence. We've even sensed, like, the concept of Gaia. We've heard the statement, think like a mountain. But how many of us do? How many of us can get out of our egocentric predicament to really experience our identity as part of a system? We can intellectually know that's true, but we don't act as if it were. I don't know about you, but this is my predicament. And it bugs me. Now, one of the things that I began to appreciate was that I was born through blessings or whatever into this particular society, which has certain kinds of myths, certain kinds of techniques of socialization that in an interesting way left me out of balance. Best way to say it. That is, when I was born, my parents, out of the best intentions, trained me to be a member of this culture. What that meant was I was trained to be an individual, trained to value individuality. I was trained into separateness, into being somebody. I was trained to identify myself with my ego. And the ego is a structure of mind. It's a map of reality. And I was trained to become somebody. Now, sometime before that, before the socialization started in earnest, I didn't have a differentiated self. And had the socialization been different, I might have learned my separate self without losing that other thing, without losing the fact that I was part of everything. Now, the awakening is the realization that that whole constellation of thoughts of who you think you are is a very limiting condition, that you are much, much, much more than that. As Trungpa Rinpoche said, enlightenment is the ego's ultimate disappointment. It's the realization that who you think you are is really kind of, it's just a functional unit within a limited scope of reality. Is this too weird for everybody? Huh? If it is, just vomit or something. And at first, when I started to recognize that who I thought I was wasn't who I was, even the concept of I was very suspect. I saw the entire plane of reality in which I was a somebody as abhorrent. And I wanted to get away from it. I wanted to get high as fast as I could, as often as I could, and stay there as long as I could. me many years to realize, A, that I couldn't stay high, and that B, high wasn't free. And that finally I wanted to be free, I didn't want to be high. And that finally I wanted to be free, I didn't want to be high. I didn't want to be high.